I need some assistance. These two gentlemen here, you're not doing a damn thing. Come up. Let's give them a hand, big guy. You can come across on the inside. Good. Hi, I'm Poppy. Your name is?
Andy.
And?
Sam.
Hi, Sam.
Hi.
Let's give Andy and Sam a big hand. Sam, does this look like a real solid object to you?
Sure does.
It's not an illusion, is it? It's a little pocket knife, am I correct?
You are correct.
A little pen knife, am I right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know why it's called a pen knife?
I don't.
Nobody
I feel like
does.
I should.
I know, everybody should, but they don't. They forget. You'll remember as soon as I tell you. They're called pen knives because in the old days they made pens out of feathers. They had to have a little knife to carve the end of the feather and make a quill pen. They called those pen knives. Thomas Jefferson, our president, invented the first folding pen knife just such as this one. So you see, the act is educational as well as entertaining. Now, when that knife reappears over here, do you know what most people will say? They'll say that wasn't magic at all. No, I know most people say it. I know you wouldn't do it, but most people say they say obviously it just went up this sleeve, came across your shoulders, down this sleeve, into your pocket, or something.
No, don't.
Well, that's what actually happened. But if I showed you the knife, Sam, and you held my wrist, and I showed you the knife, and I closed my hand, and when I opened my hand again, that knife was gone. That would not be sleight of hand.
Right. It'd be impressive.
That would be real magic. Mm-hmm. If I show you the knife and I close my hand and I open my hand, that knife is gone. That would be real magic, mm-hmm. would it not? Mm-hmm. Folks,
yeah. Yes.
If I show you the knife, close my hand, open my hand, that knife is gone. That would be real magic, would it not?
Yes.
No one can do that. Yeah. Think about it. The only way that can happen is if the magician first creates what we call the intricate web of distraction. You want to see this? Watch this closely. You're not going to believe this. Whoa. Ah! See that?
Yeah.
I know. Magic. Well, maybe not magic. Little white knife, little black knife. See, that's the secret door. I have this one hidden in what we call the palming position. From this side, you can see it, but from this side, it's a principle of magic. As long as you hold your hand in a perfectly natural fashion, you don't have to suspect that you have a knife hidden on the other side. When the white knife comes over near the black knife, that's when you switch.
What?
And then you switch back. That's the secret to the whole thing. Well, now that you know how it's done, I'll do it slow. I'll do it slow. Look. White knife over here. Sam, I'm sorry, your name
Andy.
Is? Andy. Andy. White knife over here. Which knife is in this hand? No, that's the switch, Andy. That's what I'm trying to demonstrate. I'll do it again. Obviously, you woke you up. Here, Andy, look. White knife over here. Black knife in this hand. Which knife is in this hand, Sam?
The white knife.
No? Maybe it's confusing you guys having both knives out. I'll get rid of one.
That'd be good.
Just one knife. One knife. This black knife. You hold my wrist really tight. Now we get the white knife out. It doesn't come anywhere near the black knife. You hold this wrist. Which knife is in this hand?
Black,
right?
Yeah.
Oh! Guess again.
Black knife,
good guess. Perverse, but good. Except remember what I said. Guess which knife is in my pocket?
One of the two.
Guess which?
The white knife.
No, black knife. You're not going to win.